Hey y'all. Well, it's the end of day three. We got a couple more pickups. Let's just get right to it.
All right, y'all. First, let's start off with Jamie found this Joe DiMaggio. It's a pin. It's pretty neat. I don't know much about these. I'm gonna do some research. If any of you guys know anything about it, let us know. But that's pretty cool. Jamie also, walking by, found this in a bin. It's a Trevon Diggs pedigree. It's pretty nice. The guy said he got it out of a case hit. This is another one we're gonna do some study on and let y'all know more about what we find out. It's a nice card. And then Jamie also saw this one. This one's I hadn't seen these before, but it's a potato chip card. Crane potato chips. There again, we got a lot of stuff that we're going to do some research on when we get back home. That's in good shape. That was her pickups today. I also hit the bargain bins a little bit. Found the Stan Musial. It's a die cut card. Cut to the chase. I'm not much on the more modern stuff, but I thought that was cool. So, there again, we'll be looking into this a little bit more when we get home. I found another old boxing card. Larry Gaines. It's a Churchman Cigarettes. As you can tell the back, this one's another one in really good shape. We got this one off the same dealer we got that Jack Johnson off of, and it was a Churchill Cigarettes card too. Let me see if I can find that one. Yeah. Here we go. These are both from the same company anyway. Maybe even the same year. Anyway. That was another one of our pickups. Then I found some 1950 Bowman. Really good shape. Good color. The price was just too good to pass up. Pat Mullen. And here's the other one. Gene Herminski. And the last 50 Bowman I got today. Mark Majeski? Yeah, Hank Majeski. That same dealer had this 52 tops that I'm working on. 211. It's in a 4, and as you can tell, it's miscut. But the price he gave me on the bundle deal between these and the Bowman, I can deal with that for a little while. I can always upgrade if I want to later. But the card itself presents very well. Nice color. So just miscut. It's not labeled miscut. It's a 4. That's all the singles that we got. But we did go start the day off by going by, and we bought a starter lot of these 1955 Bowman. We got them as a set, a starter lot. Got some stars in it. We haven't really gone through it completely yet. Well, that's the number one card. We got Neil. This set's also got all the umpire cards. These here are in pretty good shape. There's some of them. There's another ump card. Bob Lemon. and there's another Bob Lemon. This Bob Lemon came with the set, and this one was out of a bargain bin. This one was $2, so I picked it up. At that point, I wasn't sure what was all in the lot that we had bought. This Campanella looks really good. Just look at the back of this one. Yeah. And I'll go through these 55s that I picked up in more detail later next week. There's the Gil Hodges. And of course, there's a Barra. So these aren't in perfect shape, but they're gonna go in an album anyway. We're gonna do this one in a raw set. Those are all the stars and semi-stars. And we got this great big stack here. So we're not gonna go through all these right now. We'll go through more in detail when we get back home. But I think we got these for like $220 for the starter set. There's 92 cards in the starter set. So we were pretty happy about that. And remember, when it comes to collecting, dream big. You can always start small. And it's always for the love of the cards. Good night, guys.